many professions, you have to pass through a certain qualification period. You have to be certified, and then you can be called a qualified person in that field. But not so much in the field of being a guru, or we have so many fake babas these days. So Doug is saying that with this sort of phenomenon of where anybody can stand up and say, I'm a guru or a baba, how do you sift from, you know, the charlatans or the fake people and the people who are genuine or have some sort of, higher calling? And he's talking about how we can form a relationship with certain of these new upcoming gurus and suss out what's happening.
Okay. In fact, Doug has been known to me quite often now on the internet. And he said, please help us, Mr. Lakhani. He's from Germany. He said there is one particular Indian guru who has made a home in Germany and he's taking everybody for a ride. He's raping his devotees. I won't mention any names, and it's better not to mention any names. So he said, Mr. Lakhani, help. Please mention this guru and his, you know, horrible techniques in Germany to warn other people. You see, our audience is not German, so it's pointless for me to make this comment or even mention a particular guru by name, because this is not the way we do things. The only thing I can say is this. We can only make our audience, our viewers, aware that there are loads and loads of fake gurus. How do you discuss them out? Very simple. If a person is talking about spirituality from experience, you can straight away see that this is no make-believe, this is no gimmick. And you can make out this person is because he will not have any other motivation. He won't want to start a movement. He will not be asking for money. He will not be asking you to become his devotee. He will not be selling you some mantras or some kind of gimmicks to wear around your neck, etc. He will not try and capture you or try and, in a way, make you part of his devotee. He will avoid that. He will just talk about spirituality in a very open manner. And these are the signs of spirituality. They are not after anything from you. They don't want your devotion even. This is a sign of a true spiritual, you know, spiritually enlightened being. The wrong ones will always find some gimmick. And I see, look, forget about the gurus in the West. Gurus in India are infecting the society, doing tremendous harm to the society. And I see them left, right, and center. Mm-hmm. I feel like, you know, rolling up my sleeves and really taking them to task. But that is not my way. I don't want to fling mud at others. I'm simply warning our audience that please be aware, 99% of the gurus that are now floating in the Indian subcontinent and outside the Indian subcontinent, in the West as well, I would say 99% are fake, because I tell you why. Straight you can see, make them out. I mean, they're talking about something, they will be selling you something, that it will make you better, health-wise, will improve your health, or we got all the power to stop any serious illness, don't worry. It's nonsense, illness doesn't work. Or they'll say, we'll solve all your problems, just wear this pendant. You say, how can that be true? Doesn't seem rational. They will be asking you for devotion and they will start brainwashing you. This is another technique they use. Because the thing is, by repeatedly telling you something again and again, you get caught up. In fact, a lot of religions are just passed on, transmitted through, if you like, this repetition. Just repeat again and again. So if somebody comes on your door and repeats, you know, I won't mention him, Christian movement, and they knock on your door and say, you better believe in us or you're going to hell. And you give us, you know, rational response, and they will say, no, like a tape recorder, they just keep repeating what they've been taught. So you can straight away, these are, you know, brainwashed individuals. So these gurus will use every technique to brainwash you. And once you are brainwashed, they can take advantage of you. And we've seen this happening throughout the world with lots and lots of fake gurus, also Christian evangelical churches, some of them. So they all use these kind of weird techniques to try and capture your attention, get your money, get your devotion, and they destroy you in the end. So the only thing we can do is make our audience aware that out of 199 are charlatans, I'm telling you. Only 1% is perhaps sensible enough, you can suss them out, and then just hang on to them and avoid all those. But one other thing I must say is this. I heard this from my mentor. He said, look, a hobo student will find a hobo guru. Who are you to get in the way? If a person is gullible, he's asking for trouble, he'll get into trouble. How will you stop it? Because he's gullible. His faculties are not fully developed. So it's easy to kind of waylay him and kind of waylay, you know, take him off for a ride. And they are ready for a ride. Because a hobo student will automatically be attracted to a hobo guru. And this is the way of the world. The only thing we can say is be very, very alert. Be very careful in who you think is spiritually enlightened person to hang on to and progress.